God bless you. Let's read the word of God in Joshua 8 from 15. Joshua what? From 15. We won't talk much. This today is your day. Joshua 8.
Joshua 8.
From 15. So Joshua and all Israel pretended to be defeated by them and ran toward the wilderness. Then all the people who were in the city were called together to pursue them. And they pursued Joshua and were lured away from the city. Not a man was left in Ai or Bethel who had not gone out after Israel. So they left the city open and unguarded, and they pursued Israel. And verse 18, then the Lord said to Joshua, reach out with the spear that is in your hand and point it toward Ai, for I will give it into your hand. So Joshua reached out with the spear and in his hand and pointed it toward the city. And the men in ambush emerged quickly from the hiding place. And when Joshua stretched out his hand, they ran and entered the city and captured it and quickly set the city on fire. When the men of that land turned back and looked, behold, the smoke of the city was ascending towards the sky, and they had no opportunity to run this way or that way. Then the people who had been running to the wilderness turned back toward the pursuers. When Joshua and all Israel saw that the men in ambush had taken the city and that the smoke of the city was ascending, they turned back and struck down the men of Ai. Then the others came out of the city to confront the men of Ai as they returned, so that they were trapped in the midst of Israel, some on this side and some on the other side. Then Israel struck them until none of them survived or escaped. Let's pray. Father, thank you, Lord, for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to look at this topic. He will never allow you to be disappointed. We are serving God who will allow challenges to come. But he will never allow you to be disappointed. In other words, he won't disappoint you. We are serving God who does not disappoint. The Bible shows in Joshua 7.
So Bible Joshua 7.
The promise that was given to Joshua.
Joshua
we saw it failing in Joshua 7.
Joshua 7.
To extend that, Joshua began to cry to God. Remember that the words that were given to Joshua was every land that he put his leg belongs to him. But in that land, there were few people. And those few people were able to defeat the whole army of Israel.
And
this disappointed
Joshua.
And to extend that, God, when he looked at him, he found him slipping down crying. God said, get up. This is not the time of crying. Where we have read in Joshua
8,
we can see God, after he has strengthened Joshua, and say, now, go to these people of Bethel. Just go there, use this strategy. They know that in the beginning you were defeated. But separate yourself
Marate aruhanye.
Have a group that approached the gate.
Ebale group ye yang horong.
And the group that is behind the city.
Le group ye ngwe yang kamrawa mose.
So now, when these people,
Shonong batuma,
when they see Israel approaching,
Aba bona ba Israel ba itla.
They were told that when they approach there, they must turn and run away like they're afraid.
Shonong aba bona ba itai, ba tsonchoro ba drukuluwe ba no shaba.
The people of the city of Ai,
batuma mutsola wa Ai,
when they see the Israel running away,
Aba bona ba Israel ba chabai.
They thought they are still going to do what they have done. Whereas it was the best strategy of finishing them. I want to speak with you today that the best strategy of destroying the enemy is like running away from the enemy. When we read here, we see that they were pretending like they are defeated. But it was a best strategy of destroying these people. When they ran away, the people of Ai pursued them. All of them, they had confidence
that
no one was left in the city. That's what we have read. And the Bible says, God spoke with Joshua and said, point with your spear in the land of
Ai.
And when he did that, those who hide behind, they rose up and enter inside and destroy everything. Later, the people of Ai realized that they've got nowhere to run to because already they were between the army that was behind and the one that was approaching the gate. When I was reading this, I realized that there are things that has happened before us. And those who created those things, they want to do the same thing again. So that you feel like you have to be like afraid and you are defeated. But here is the method of God. That when you see the same thing, it's not to bring disappointments. It's not to bring a defeat. Turn away again. Act like you are running away. But your enemy will be defeated. There's a method that God is establishing that when you are quiet, you are a winner. When you are running away, you are confusing the enemy. Can I tell you this? Today we are here to confuse our enemies. Act like you are running away. Because God will never disappoint you. And your enemies will never leave to speak any testimony against you. I don't know if you are hearing me. When I read Romans 5 verse 5, it says such promises never disappoint us. Because God's love has been abundantly poured out within our hearts through the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Listen to this. There are promises. Joshua was given promise. You will conquer wherever you go. But these promises, it's not like they are coming the way we think. Sometimes we expect them, or we wait for too long. But we have got hope unto him that he who promised, he is the fulfiller of the promise. And such promise, will never disappoint us. I can see God honoring someone here. The promise that you have been given for many years, it will never disappoint you. And He will never disappoint you. It will come to pass in your life. If you believe, shout hallelujah. But I'm here to tell you, God will never allow you to be disappointed. On what God has promised on you, I want to give you 2 weeks. Those promises will start to happen. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Listen, I'm here to prophesy you. To declare to you. I'm not here to preach to you. When you face what you are facing, don't forget that He who promised will never disappoint you. I don't know if you are hearing me. Can I tell you this? Sometimes when you are seeing challenges, you can cry and kneel down and ask God why. There was a time when I was seeing some challenges. I even had asked myself many questions. Until I conclude by saying, I don't care about blessing as long as I'm going to heaven. Because when you are waiting for the promises, you must guard your life. You must live right. Because the one who promised is not a liar like man. He will make sure that the promise He gave you will come to pass in your life. I can see you were disappointed, but we are serving God who will never disappoint you. I say, I see that things that are happening in your life, sometimes you don't even understand. I went through the same situation. I went through questions and asked myself, if I'm serving God, why I'm facing 1, 2, 3. But I'm here to tell you the same thing that I told myself, that, but God will never disappoint me. I can still face whatever. I can still hear people speaking against me. But God will never disappoint me. I can still be sick and face rejection. But God will never disappoint me. Just check on Monday. Tomorrow Monday, you will realize that this message was for you. Because God will never disappoint you. I don't know if you are hearing me. Sometimes, when you look at your situation, you feel like there's a delay or time is going. Hey. Sometimes God will delay you so that what comes will make people to praise your God. Hey, you are not disappointed. It's a plan of the living God. I don't know if you are hearing me. The moment when I learned about disappointments, I found that it's not there in our God. It's people who can disappoint you. People can really disappoint. You can trust people, but they will disappoint you. Not God. I see God raising someone. I see God raising someone. Say, hey, my God will never disappoint me. Some people are saying, it's long you are in Charis. We can't see any change in your life. Others are talking too much. I've got a good word for you. As they are busy talking, look unto Him, the author and the finisher of your faith. He is about to reward you. The Bible says, he who comes to Him must believe He is. We know He is. able to do above than what they think. I can see people who are here. There is something that God is about to do about what they think. About what they think. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Many people who are facing disappointments, they face them from people. Many of you can't trust because your trust was broken. Sometimes you are failing even to reach out because you are afraid of being hurt again. Sometimes you are even afraid to extend your hand because you know what happened. It happened to Joshua. Joshua faced the defeat. And God said, hey, now you are going the same place. Just organize yourself. Make sure that everything about yourself is clean. Separate yourself with people who are not clean. Rise up. You don't need to pray. Go back to the same challenge. You can overcome it. You can move forward. You can defeat the same enemy that has defeated you. You can defeat. You can rise up to do things in a better way. I don't know if you are hearing me. Maybe you wed and you fail. You can do a better wedding. Maybe you were rejected in the family. You can be a celebrity of this land. Maybe you are poor. I prophesy you. Maybe you are poor. I'm here to tell you, your God will never disappoint you. Will never disappoint you. You are disappointed. You are afraid. You don't even want to have friends. I see friends that will lift you. I see friends that will raise you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. So I'm here to tell you that disappointment by a person is a promotion by God. The moment they disappoint you, it's a promotion to you. If you carry on focusing on what has happened to you, you won't move forward. Look ahead where God is telling you. There's a place where God is taking you. I don't know if you are hearing me. The moment someone you trust tell you that you are useless, hey, stop crying. Don't fast like Joshua. Rise up. Organize yourself. Fix yourself. Just have an ego.
Move
by the standard of his word. When you move forward, you will understand that failure was working for the best for you. Everything which are worse are working for the best things that are supposed to come to you. One time I told one man, I say, you are divorced. He was very worrying. He said, try everything.
Don't waste time.
Deal with yourself. Go to saloon. Clean yourself. Wear nice things. Now search for a better person than that one. When you get the better person, pass on the same street. Walking slowly. Your hand is here. Slowly. When you want to pass the windows, just stand, you hold the hand like this. Talk. Even when you are talking nonsense, just talk. From there, carry on. Talk. Tomorrow do the same.
Kau sane letokwa.
I said, you will hear a call.
Letokwa mala ulla.
You will just say, sorry, are you around?
Sorry, wanana.
You hear somebody using God, say, God told me I must come back to you.
Mordimo
say, God forbid.
Kore modimo ya ana.
Listen to this.
Chilecha.
Stop crying. Stop kneeling down. Rise up and tune yourself. Because the victory belongs to you. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you do things better, even God will honor you. I see someone here today. I'm seeing someone here. You have been facing disappointment in your work, in your business, in your family, in
relationships.
I say, rise up. I say, behold, there's a light in front of you. I see the light in front of you. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Can you shake somebody and say, hey, I see a light in front of you. Let me show you a scripture. Maybe this scripture will help you. If you read Psalm 25:20, maybe it will help you. Because you are dwelling too much in disappointments. Psalm 25:20. Are you there?
Later, say,
guard my soul and rescue me. Do not let me be ashamed or disappointed. For I have taken refuge in you. If you want to know that that promise will come, what you need to do, make sure that you live right. And make sure that it's only God that you trust. Allow God to be your refuge. What is the meaning of refuge? When you are hurt, you run there. When you are rejected, you run there. When you are opposed, you run there. Even when you are blessed, you belong there. Can I tell you this? God will never allow you to be ashamed. There are some people here that already they were asking themselves if God is with them in their decision. God is there, Just deal with yourself. Allow God to be a center of where you run to. Run to Him. If there are any challenges you are facing, allow God to be the only one who knows your problem. And that problem will be solved. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
If you read Romans 10:11, the Bible says, for the scriptures say, whoever believes in him will not be disappointed in his expectation.
Amen.
If you believe in him, you will never be disappointed in your expectation. I just want to ask you, what are you expecting? There's something I wanted to tell you, that God will never do anything until you put something in your mind. I don't know if you're hearing that. Our God is not a magician. He will never do anything without your expectation. You must put something in your mind. If you are putting Toyota Yaris, it is your expectation. So God will always look at your trust and believe and do above. Do you know that what you are having is above what you were thinking? If it's coming from God, but if it's coming from you, it is your labor. I don't know if you're hearing me. So God always wants you to think above. Or you think and you put something in your prayers. When God wants to honor you, He looks what you are praying for. He knows that what you are praying for, you are praying it because you believe in Him. You are hoping in Him. You trust Him that He can do that. You will see God doing the best. When I was in Malamulele Stadium, I called several people. I was like standing here, they were there. I could hear it clear that if anybody says something when I'm there, and that thing, it means he believed that thing, it will happen. I even told those people that the reason why God is not answering you is because you are asking what God is not having. God does not have small things for His children. If you ask small things, it will take time to come to you. You need to know who you are, because there is something in you which is bigger than the one in the world. If you find yourself, even your prayers will be different. I don't know if you are hearing me. You can ask big things, they will happen. Your expectation is very, very important. I see God honoring your expectation. Your expectation is about to land in this land. I see you having something that nobody in your family can have that. If you believe, say amen. Can you ask your neighbor, what are you expecting? Do you believe God? And your friend say what? From here, 2 to 3 days to come, many of you are going to face temptation, so that now you reason below the ability of God, so that you don't even think that God can do what He was saying. Many of you from Monday, Tuesday, you see. But the moment you stand on what you are saying now here, this week will never be finished without your testimony. I don't know if you're hearing me. Ask somebody, say, what are you expecting? Listen, you must believe God. You must believe God. I was looking on the issue of John the Baptist when he was born, when the angel went to the Father, and as he was busy inside the house of God. And to extend that, the angel say, because you are not believing, it's better your mouth will be shut. Because this man was there, pray for people. Pray for people, honoring things, speaking. You could not do anything there without talking. It's you who are talking, say, okay, now I'm praying, okay, thank you, Lord. But now when the angel entered there, he found that this man is just doing this without expectation. You see, you are in the church of God. You say amen. Hallelujah. Nothing. But God say, okay, now we want to give you a promise. You look at yourself. Me having a child. Me having a car. Me having a car. And the angel says, no, this guy is not fit. Let me silence him. We have got many Christians that they are in the place where the Holy Spirit is. And you find God is speaking with them. When God wants to give them things, He presents them as knowledge. When they accept that knowledge, their mind fights back. They try to show them where they come from. This is not the time of looking where you come from. This is the time of looking where God is taking you. I don't care about where you come from. I don't care where you were born. I can see where you are going. I can see where you are going. God will never disappoint you. God will never disappoint you. This is not a message, it's a prophecy for you. Can you see what you are facing now? Where you are waking? Can you see what you are facing? When you are trying to get money? The challenges you are facing is just to say, oh God, I have prayed all prayers. I can't see anything. Can I tell you this? God will never disappoint you. I'm telling you now, God will never disappoint you. In the process where all hopes are gone, you will enter and declare something. I'm entering now. I declare something on you. When your hopes are gone, my God is beginning to do a new thing in your life. Today is your day for a new thing to happen in your life. If you believe, shout hallelujah. When everything you have tried, you have failed, and you think it's over with you, my God is starting something. Can you ask your neighbor, what is it that you think God can do in your life? If truly our God is alive, why are we supposed to help him? Well, you know, you must know that God is alive, is big God. Why are we supposed to bring a false prophet? Why are we supposed to bring a charm? I'm here to tell you, this God we are serving is Jehovah. He will never disappoint you. I say he will never disappoint you. I see promotion where you are working. I see promotion where you are working. Listen, from now on, you must tell your situation and say, my situation, you don't know my God. You don't know my God. You don't know my God. You know, there was something that I used to do. I'm no longer doing it. But I want to do it again. When I was still staying in my shack, I used to turn around my shack. When I'm in my shack, I began to say, I hate you. You are not part of me. You are a curse. And I break you. Because I'm going to my house. I know my God. I'm just making you favor. I'm about to leave you. You shake. You belong to my enemy. You are not mine. Let me give you the last scripture. Sit down. Because talking too much, it won't help me. Can I give you the last scripture? You read this scripture. If you read Psalm 22, 1 to 5, it's your scripture.
Pisalem
is what Jesus called this scripture. On the cross. But I want to show you something there. From verse 1, my God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from helping me? From the words of my groaning. Can you see that? Yeah, oh my God, verse 2. I call out by day, but you do not answer. And by night, but I found no rest nor quiet. But you are holy.
Amen.
Oh, you who are enthroned in the holy place where the praises of Israel are offered. Verse 4. In you our father trusted or relied on or were confident. And they trusted, and you rescued them. Verse 5, they cried out to you, and were delivered. They trusted in you, and were not disappointed or ashamed. This was David saying this. Even Jesus When he was on the cross, he was quoting this scripture. I don't know what kind of cross are you on. Jesus suffered shame because of the glory. You are suffering shame. There is the glory in front of you. I don't know what you are facing. But there is something that I know about you. Though you are facing this, trust that he will never disappoint you. Just trust that he's doing it. You know, I just want us to trust him. I'm just giving this, not because of anything. There was a house that I was staying in with my wife. When I started to move from Kempton Park. When I went to that house, I was not happy. I once told some people in this church, the house is true, it was double story, it was a very big house. After I extend my house, I felt my life will end here. My wife said, no. This place, this house is nice. We can stay. And can I tell you this? It was expensive to pay it by month. Because even the offering of this church could not make the rent of that house. My wife said to me, let's trust God. We have the house there that we don't pay, but let's go out and rent this one. And for me to know that place is when my son was attending school. And he was playing soccer. So we were called to come and see our children when they are playing. So when we reached there, there were those houses. My wife said, I want to stay here. So by the following morning, she forced me, we went there. The house was expensive. And I thank God I'm no longer staying there. Even now, I thank God I'm not going to stay. So my wife said, let's move here. But let's believe God that he will give us money. You know, I was shocked. I agreed. I said, okay, that's fine because I want to do everything for you. We went there. That person said, when I look at you, you must give us two installments and a deposit. In other words, we were not even suitable to stay there. We were not even trusted. What I was having is what those people were having. Mama said, let's take all our money we have, we do it. I said, Mama, very soon it's like we'll go back to our house. In fact, I just agree knowing that we will fail and go back. I look at my wife, she was trusting God so much. And by then, we were having a pulpit that side. Our pulpit was that side. And our church was very small. You know what happened?
That's about Yalang.
After church, this man I don't even know. He came and gave me a rent of that house. I don't know if you're hearing that. I was so shocked. I spoke with Mama. I said, I found the money. I don't know this man. But he came here and said, God said, I must give you this. I say, let's trust God. I don't know if you're hearing that. Do you trust God? He will never disappoint you. I want you people who are here, I want to teach you this thing, you can do it. The house you are paying on is yours. It's a bond house. It's yours. All right, can you go out and rent another one? And believe that God will never disappoint you. You will pay up this one and buy another one. And be a landlord for that house you are paying. Can you do that? How many of you can do that? You are afraid. God bless you. I want us to stand. Ask your neighbor, do you believe God won't disappoint you? Do you believe in Him? Are you sure? Are you sure you believe that what you are searching, you'll get it? Are you sure? I'm giving you these 2 weeks. It will happen. I'm expecting 2 or 3 or 5 weddings same time. Do you believe it can happen? I'm expecting you people here coming here with big testimonies that will shame the devil. Amen. Do you believe it will happen? Amen. I'm expecting your enemy to bow in front of you. Amen. They will praise your God. Amen. I said they will praise your God. Amen. There's something that me as a pastor, I've never done that. And I will never do it. And I want pastors to do the same. They must believe in their calling. They must not believe in people. If they do that, God will always send people. God will always send people. Pastors, believe in your calling. Don't believe in people. People, they can't do anything. They will give you what you are asking. I want to tell you who is a follower in the church, a Christian. Believe in your God. Don't believe in your friend in the church. Amen. Believe in what? Because people are here to deprive one another. Believe in what? If you believe in your God, God will honor you. Amen. Are you ready for that?